We read a lot of your comments on our resin versus FDM video and decided to push an FDM printer to its absolute limits to see if it could compete with resin. And well, maybe you were right. Hello 3D printing friends, how are you? My name is Adam, and today we're going to see if it's possible to print Loot Studio's high-quality 32mm miniatures with FDM printers instead of resin ones. We're back at YouTube again, and if you like 3D printing and slightly questionable experiments, smash that like button before we break something. Moving on. Here at Loot, we're impressed with the ease of use of the Bambu Lab FDM printer, and last year we tested it with one of our most iconic playable terrains, our huge pirate ship, the Lady Harpy. We printed it with a 0.2mm layer height at high speed, and it came out perfectly, as you can see. However, we know you want to go beyond printing more prominent parts, so we will perform some tests with our miniatures on a 32mm scale. Can FDM capture all the details? Let's find out. You know that our pieces have a high level of detail and that the most suitable technology to produce them is MSLA printers, which use resins as they can reproduce all the characteristics regardless of the complexity of the model. But when it comes to FDM printing, the process is different, right? Some 32mm models may be more suited than ours for FDM printing, but they end up lacking realistic proportions and dynamic poses that you'll find here. In the Bambu Studio, the software slices the models with many variables, such as infill, supports, retract, speed, and other points. But in this video, we will experiment with two key parameters, the layer height and the nozzle diameter. We'll use the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon printer, which prints fast and delivers excellent quality due to auto-flow calibration and vibration compensation. With this printer, you don't need to be an expert in FDM settings. To begin this journey, we will use two models from our welcome pack, the famous Tavern Keeper, which is a simpler model with fewer fine details, and the Guardian Firebeard, with his super detailed armor. So beautiful. With the printer's default presets using the nozzle of 0.4mm and PLA filament, we will run an initial test at three different layer heights that will influence the quality of the models and printing time. First, the draft quality is 0.24mm layer height. We already knew that it wouldn't look good, but we printed them just for comparison since it took only 40 minutes to print these two pieces in their bases. The second was the fine configuration with 0.12mm layer thickness. This print took around 80 minutes and the result improved significantly. However, the fine details of Gardein's clothing are still poorly represented. Shall we go to the extra fine configuration? For this one, we tried printing with a 0.08mm layer height. The print took 2 hours and we have already noticed a better representation of the finer details. It is far from the intended result, but it is still an astonishing outcome for this configuration. Now here's something we noticed during our tests. Some of the thinner, more detailed parts of the miniatures ended up breaking during support removal. This happened because Loot Studio's miniatures are designed for resin printers, which can handle highly dynamic poses and intricate details better than FDM printers. Guardian's hammer, for example, has a thinner grip than the support itself. But don't worry, we quickly solved this with a simple fix, a small dab of super glue on the broken parts with glue accelerator, and the miniatures were as good as new. So, if you're printing Loot Studio's miniatures on an FDM printer, keep some super glue handy, just in case. When printing with filament, a determining factor is increasing the quality of the parts in the printing speed. We know that this machine is an unleashed beast when it comes to velocity. But if you're printing smaller parts, reducing the printer speed will help you increasing the quality. After all, we all know that rush is perfection's nemesis. In the slicer, the printing speed is the difference between the high quality setting and the extra fine with 0.08 layers height. Printing the same minis using this high quality preset at a lower speed, we got to these results. For the two models, the printer needed almost 3 hours and we didn't notice any great difference between these and the previous ones. Since the Bambu X1 is a state-of-the-art FDM printer, its stabilization system handles the faster printing process pretty well. Now that we know which settings generated the best quality when printing 32mm miniatures using the 0.4mm nozzle, we selected other characters and scenery objects to print using the same settings just to show you the results. As expected, the scenery objects printed well, but some areas of the filament print become more fragile depending on the model's positioning. This shows a significant limit for this technology, so you must carefully handle it. We also achieved good results in this humanoid miniature, with a thin bow and this fin, with many delicate parts in contact with the supports. In addition to these models, we selected one of our dragons to print in these configurations, and despite being more robust, it has very fine spines, claws, and teeth that were printed without any problems. From a certain distance, it is almost possible to mistake it for resin, but looking closely, the difference is still there. The differences are more visible in areas where the supports made contact with the model. Now that you've seen our test results, let's dive deep into some essential configurations for printing 32mm miniatures. The nerdy stuff! So far in these tests, we have only printed using three supports, which we know are easier to remove after printing. We used the default configuration, but there are slim, strong, hybrid, and organic options that are very according to the way the supports are automatically created. The typical supports, the grid, and the snug covered a good part of the miniature, making it very difficult to remove, so we only printed a few pieces to show you. Out of curiosity, we printed one piece with similar supports we made for the resin printer. However, even considering the thickness limitation that this FDM printer can reproduce, we obtained supports attached to the model, which is not ideal for fragile pieces. In the slicer, some options in the support tab can be changed. Still, the only one we modified was the three support branch diameter, which was changed from 2mm to 1.5, reducing the diameter of the support tip and making it easier to remove and print small miniatures with tiny details. If you have supports that are very stuck to the model, you should run some tests varying the top Z distance to create supports that are easier to remove with less damage possible to the model. And if you still are having some struggle to remove supports from the piece, here's a good piece of advice. Use flush cutting pliers for the removal. And remember, be gentle. Miniatures are small. The supports can be placed automatically by the slicer, but in some cases, it is interesting to use the support painting, which allows you to select specific locations for the program to generate the supports, or even block them. This way, the stability of some model parts can be increased during printing. During this part, it is important to seek balance regarding the amount of supports. On one hand, if we have more supports, they may become more difficult during the removal and the risk of damaging the minis increases. But, on the other hand, if we put less supports, the chance of printing errors goes up. It's all about balance. But 3D printing isn't just about support. Other configurations must be taken into account to achieve the best quality in specific areas. Okay. Now that we understand the supports, let's move on to another critical factor, layer seams. This can make the difference between a smooth face and a miniature full of print marks. In FDM printing, the nozzle begins and ends each layer at a specific point, the seam. This is where we can see a slight imperfection in the piece. We may notice a significant loss of quality on the character's face when we left a seam in this area. Since the software allows you to choose the positioning of this point, the main thing to do is set the seam in the back of the printing table and position the models facing the front of the printer. However, if you want to achieve even more detailed minis, there is the seam painting option, where you can choose the location with more precision. But we are not yet in our final set for the best results. What? Did you think we had already reached the quality limit? Not yet. Let's push the boundaries even further. Let's talk about the ace of our sleeve, the nozzle. Now we'll try with an even thinner nozzle with a 0.2 mm diameter. By installing a thinner nozzle, we can obtain an even better result. This way, we will have a high definition of finer textures with more defined and sharp corners. We can easily replace the entire hot end kit in the Bambu Lab printer and select the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon printer profile with a 0.2 mm nozzle in the slice software. This way, presets with layer heights from 0.14 to 0.06 are available. However, we will focus on printing the characters with maximum quality, using 0.06 mm layers at reduced speed. Here's the best result for 32 mm miniatures. Despite these two models taking more than 5 hours, we can now see all the richness of the details better than all the other configurations. Look at this difference! What do you think? Is the extra printing time worth it? We were expecting that the removal of supports would be easier, since the supports became more fragile. But that ended up being like the previous prints. Although we could see more details in the 32mm miniatures, some of them broke during this process due to thin parts in the models, such as their teeth and weapons. Nothing that a little glue can solve, right? Detail-wise, I think we've achieved our best results for now. Maybe if we manage to print our highly detailed minis without support removal breakage, we can come back with a second part of this video. Who knows? What do you think? To get things rolling, we will make one more comparison. Here's another albino dragon from our Reign of the Cold Heart bundle. In this case, the only difference is the nozzle diameter. We changed from 0.4 mm to 0.2 mm and printed with the same layer height of 0.08 mm. In this piece, it was possible to see a clear difference in some areas, mainly in the teeth and spines, but the printing time was almost double with a thinner nozzle. However, in this model, some printing lines appeared, which could have several causes. But by running the print again, we can probably eliminate these lines. Okay, we've now come to the ultimate detail level that we could achieve using our FDM printer, and the result is pretty good. And none of the thinner pieces of the dragon broke during the support removal. Now, I bet some of you are thinking, all right, but what about the cost? Is my wallet taking a hit or catching a break? And for that, my fellow loader, we'll talk about money. One key factor in choosing between FDM and resin printing is cost. While resin printers offer higher detail, they come with additional expenses. Resin itself is significantly more expensive than PLA or other filament materials used in FDM printing. A liter of resin can cost between $30 to $50, while a spool of PLA filament is around $20 and lasts much longer. The difference between the material is almost imperceptible when we talk about 32mm miniatures, but it gets much more tangible when it comes to larger models, such as big terrains or statues, since there is an approximate 30% higher spend on resin when compared to filament. Additionally, resin printing requires other consumables, such as isopropyl alcohol for cleaning and UV curing for post-processing, increasing the overall cost per print. FDM printing, on the other hand, is much more affordable in the long run. Filament is cheaper and there's no need for extensive post-processing materials. However, achieving high detail on miniatures with FDM requires more time and fine-tuned settings. And there's a limit of how far you can get in detail level and resistance in small areas. If you are on a budget and willing to optimize settings, FDM can be a cost-effective way to print miniatures. But if ultimate detail is your focus, resin printing might still be worth the investment. Now that you've seen all the tests we have done, we want to know your opinion. Which configuration you use to bring your RPG table to life? A little less quality with a conventional nozzle spending less time, or trying to get the details as high as possible regardless of the time it takes to print? Maybe you even prefer your minis printed in resin, if you know how it's done. After all these tests, it's clear that FDM printers can produce impressive miniatures, but resin still takes the crown for detail. If you enjoyed this experiment, don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss our next 3D printing adventure. Thanks for joining me today, and until next time, happy printing! Bye!